Hello again, folks. It's Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair, and today we're demonstrating a unit sent in by Mike in Woodinville, Washington. This is out of a 1972 Ford LTD. Excuse me. It was an AM 8-Track. It is now an AM FM 8-Track with Bluetooth, and we're just going to run it through all its paces quickly before we give it back to the customer, make sure everything's working right. Let's go ahead and turn it on. And the first thing we'll do is demonstrate the balance and faders. So we're gonna put our unit in the upper left-hand corner here, and we're gonna switch to our output level meter so we can see what we're doing here. And as you can see, we're a little heavy on the front speakers. Now the left-right balance control, that is the original balance control. So that's the original balance control there, but this also now has a front rear fader in the tone control. If you take the tone control, rotate it twice to the right, and then you'll hear a beep, or you'll hear a voice prompt, whichever this module uses, letting you know that you're getting ready to adjust the fader. So let's go ahead and, on this model, I'm sure it's just beeps. So we're going to turn our tone control twice to the right, listen for our four beeps, and then we'll be able to use this control to adjust our front rear fader action. So here we go. Okay, four beeps. Okay, and now this control is adjusting front rear using the tone control front. Rear, all the way front, all the way rear. Okay, I'm going to take my hand off the adjustment. And one beep lets you know that the setting has been saved, and now this tone control is once again just a tone control. Alrighty, so we've taken care of that. Let's go back to just the radio, and we'll go ahead and run it all the way across the dial, and make sure we pick up a good 25-30 FM stations.
The pressing question I had was that.
Okay, there's five. Turn it down a little bit. There's 10.
9255.
Okay, there's about 20 so far.
Yeah, he signed his first deal at 14. Story because the Paramount. Let's come see.
Giving her. Okay, that's 30 right there. Okay, so this one's picking about 32. It is night, and reception's probably a little bit better at night, so that explains why this one picks up a little more than the other ones that I demonstrated. And there's not much. It is 11:30 at night right now, and there may not be anything on the AM band, but let's go ahead and switch it to AM. And if the radio did not have an original AM-FM switch, then we just turn it off, turn it right back on within about a half a second to switch bands. So here we go, off, on. Okay, and now we're on AM.
Story. It makes international news.
Okay, so it's pretty typical AM reception for nighttime. I'm kind of surprised we got one station in, actually. So let's go ahead and switch it back to FM. Okay, and now we're going to activate the Bluetooth just to make sure that it activates. If it successfully activates, there will be a female voice coming on saying, ready to pair. So let's try that. To activate the Bluetooth, one way we can activate it is to give the volume control two quick turns to the right. So here we go.
Ready to pair.
Okay, And there's our female voice saying ready to pair, and the unit is now trying to pair with a Bluetooth device, and of course I don't have one handy right now to pair it with, and so it's just going to come back on 90 seconds later and saying pairing not completed, but we've made sure that it does go into that mode. And then here's the hole I cut in the bottom for the Bluetooth antenna, and I just covered that with a little piece of stiff paper there so nothing can get down into it. Bluetooth antenna allows the Bluetooth to pick up without having to go through your dash in the dial phase. It just kind of goes under the dash and picks up that way around the bottom of the dash. Okay, and now we're going to test the A-track function. And this is Barry's A-track repair, so you're gonna get some loud, clean sound out of this A-track. A lot more treble than you're probably going to want, but with an older tape that's lost a lot of its treble, you're going to want that extra treble. So I'm just going to go ahead and back this tone control up to about halfway before I stick a tape in there, and here we go. Now that is bright sounding. Switch tracks several times. Okay, that's that female voice saying, pairing not completed on the Bluetooth. Just switch tracks two more times.
I tell my blues they mustn't show, but soon these tears are bound to.
Alrighty, and just for fun, let's try a little Jeannie C. Riley. They're probably not going to come after me for copyright on this. Keep Harbor Valley PTA very short so they don't nail me for copyright and turn the audio off. Alrighty, pull the tape out, radio comes back on by itself. This customer did not request an auxiliary input, so there is not one installed, most likely because he already has a Bluetooth and he can stream wirelessly from his phone or portable audio device. So it's about time for me to get on out of here, get on to the next video. This is Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. If you have an 8-Track player or a Classic Car Radio in need of service and conversion to FM, you can reach me at 928-533-9666. My website is in the description below. Thank you very much for watching and listening. We'll see you next time.